Hey Grio fam, I'm Justin Walters. Today is Tuesday, August 17th, and welcome to TheGrio Top 3, where we count down the top trending stories of the day. Coming in at number 3, Naomi Osaka tears up during her first press conference since her mental health break. Tennis reporter Van Rothenberg tweeted out that Osaka began to cry after a media member asked her a fairly aggressive tone question about how she benefits from a high media profile but doesn't like talking to media. Osaka was seen wiping away tears, pulling her hat over her face, and stepping away from the podium momentarily before finishing the press conference. Osaka previously removed herself from the French Open due to mental health issues and explained she did not want to participate in the mandatory media sessions. In Osaka's stirring essay for Time magazine entitled, "It's Okay Not to Be Okay," she detailed her relationship to the press and questioned the way press conferences operate in sports today. "I'm always trying to answer genuinely and from the heart," she wrote. "I've never been a media trained, so what you see is what you get. The way I see it, the reliance and respect from the athlete to the press is reciprocal. However, in my opinion, the press conference format itself is out of date and in great need of a refresh. I believe that we can make it better and more interesting and more enjoyable for each side." Next up at number 2, Dr. Dre's estranged daughter, LaTanya Young, is launching a GoFundMe page to find a home for her and her 4 children. She says she's in a desperate situation and needs help. In an interview with the Daily Mail, LaTanya revealed she's been living out of a rented SUV while she worked for DoorDash as her children live with friends for the time being. LaTanya's GoFundMe page is entitled "Help Tanya," raise money for housing and shelter, and has raised over $6,000 as of today. The official description from the page reads, "This fundraiser is to help LaTanya and her 4 kids find a safe and stable home. She's currently working at DoorDash to keep afloat, and these funds will be deeply appreciated. Thank you so much. We're wishing you the best, LaTanya." And our top story of the day at number 1, Lil Wayne opens up about surviving a suicide attempt at the age of 12. The New Orleans native recently spoke candidly on Emmanuel Acho's podcast, "Uncomfortable Conversations with a Black Man." The incident was sparked after his aunt scolded him for ditching school and discouraged his music career. Wayne admits to having suicidal thoughts and grabbed the gun from his mother's bedroom with intentions to end his life. Wayne went on to say, quote, "I was just looking and was like, you know what? I started thinking I had to get myself mad, and then I noticed I didn't have to. That's what scared me." Wayne continued, "When you have no one to vent to and no one to get this out to, you can't bring it out to your friends at school because you're still trying to be cool with them. You're not trying to let them know, I got something going on at home." Thankfully, music has been a saving grace of sorts. "That's what I love," he gushed. "That's who I am, a simple cliche. That's who I was born to be." We're certainly grateful to still have the rap icon with us. Thanks for watching this edition of TheGrio Top 3. I'm Justin Walters. For more videos like this, head over to youtube.com/TheGrio. And of course, for the latest stories of the day, TheGrio.com. Thanks for watching.